Hello, I'm Raj Chengappa. As the water crisis worsens across India, recent estimates say that by the next decade, we will have only half the amount of water each of us need. But there is a remarkable example that we could all learn from in the western Indian state of Gujarat. 20 years ago, the people of the state suffered from chronic water shortage, both for drinking water and for farming. In fact, in 2003, when India Today magazine did a major story titled Thirsty India, the cover picture of the magazine captured the plight in the village. There was a huge well in Gujarat's Limdi Taluka, and hundreds of villagers crowding around it just to get a bucket of water. Today, in 2021, the story is vastly different. The same well is now awash with water, with a dried-up lake full to the brim. You will see the woman on the right is a local, Sona Vagela, who described how she would spend hours daily filling water from drying wells, witnessing quarrels and occasional fights to get the maximum water. But today, not just her family, but every house in the village has water on tap. All this could become possible because of a branch of the Narmada Canal that started supplying water to the area around 2008. When I toured various parts of Gujarat recently, I saw the Narmada Canal form a green highway across the state, and the scenes were truly joyful. All this was not an easy transformation. I spoke to Gujarat's Principal Secretary for Water Resources, Dhananjay Dwivedi, to understand how the state did it. This is what he told me.
To appreciate what has happened in water sector in Gujarat, you need to understand the context in which Gujarat was in 80s and 90s. So historically, if you look at it, the water resources of Gujarat, like 80% of the water resources, they are found in south of this area. Most of the rivers, dams, etc., hardly in 20-25% of the area. If you look at Saurashtra and Kutch, then almost entire part you would find in the DDP or the DPAP areas, which meant effectively that every year one or other district of Saurashtra or Kutch, they would invariably face droughts. Besides that, there were water quality issues. Now, if you recall, 86 to 89, we had like drought for 3 years. And that was the time when at the peak of the crisis, we had to actually run water tankers in trains from Viramgam and Ahmedabad all the way to Saurashtra, Rajkot. There used to be cases when people would fight for the water, which would be known in urban areas as water riots. So in 2000, when the Narmada Master Plan was finalized, government appreciated the importance of water being available as a resource in the Narmada Canal, and it prepared the utilization plan, how it will be utilized for irrigation purposes, how it will be utilized for the drinking water purposes. So government started working on setting up the first pumping station in Dhaki. Over last 20 years, government lifting water in Dhaki, putting them into different A network, B network, C network and D network, has taken water for drinking water purposes to each and every corner of Saurashtra as well as Kutch. So 2002 to 2012, that was the peak time when the entire grid that you see that started come along. Thereafter, government realized that it's not just about drinking water, it's about comprehensive water management. So you need to do something about the irrigation as well. So at that time, government started looking at how can they use the additional water available in the Narmada that just flows off during the rainy season to use for irrigation as a supplemental source. That's when the government conceptualized the SONI. So under the SONI scheme, more than 125 small dams, major and medium and small dams, they have been connected through pipelines to carry surplus water of Narmada and fill them during the season whenever it is required. After that, in 2017, government realized that more needs to be done to make sure that whatever water, rainwater is available, that is harvested, conserved, that is not allowed to run off to sea or elsewhere. So then government created a massive program, which is known as the Sujalam Suflam Jal Sanchay Abhiyan. More than 43 lakh hectare area, the work has happened. More than 43 lakh cubic meter of soil has been taken out. So that much of additional storage potential has been created.
When Narendra Modi took over as Gujarat's chief minister for the first time, this was in 2001. Though never having held a ministerial post before his elevation, Modi was well aware of the problems of the state. The new chief minister saw supply of water as central to the socio-economic transformation that he wanted to bring about. So Narendra Modi laid down four major principles to ensure that his vision would work. First, Modi set aside enough money to set up the infrastructure to harness the Narmada canal, that including branch and sub canals, pump houses, laying pipes, and constructing storage reservoirs all across the state, apart from other infrastructure for supply of water. In the past 2 decades, Gujarat has spent over rupees 1 lakh crore just building up the water infrastructure to harness the Narmada canal and other things. I'm standing at the main Saurashtra canal, what is called the Convergent Bay, and you can listen to the water gushing. It's a tremendous sight. What happens here is that just below those entire row of what are called pumps that you can see over there, right across from that end to that end, water is at 11 meter below level this. Now, because there needs to be a gradient, this water is lifted by those pumps all the way here and then pushed the other side towards Saurashtra. And I have here with me Mr. Parmar, who is the executive engineer in charge of this entire pumping area, as well as looking at the irrigation that's at. Mr. Parmar, tell us simply, what happens here? Why do we need to pump it at close to 11 meters to supply the irrigation there?
Right, sir. You are aware that the Saurashtra region is like inverted saucer type. So we are standing at the edge of one saucer. So after that, the gradient, natural gradient, is upwards. And we are distributing this water to Doli Daja Dam, which is 40 kilometers away from here and which is 69 meters higher compared to this level. So we have divided that 69 meter into 5 steps, and we are step-wise lifting the water and flowing through canal. Once we will lift it, it will go through gravity to the next pumping station. Likewise, total 5 pumping stations are there, and we are sending this water to that dam.
So overall lifting will be how many meters?
Total 69 meter we are lifting.
So 69 to 70 meters means that we're looking at a building of 23 stories.
Correct.
That high you have to lift the water to push it down to this. How many farmers and area wise does this service?
Sir, it is approximately 5 lakh hectare land we are irrigating through this canal network.
And in terms of farmers, how much would you estimate? Several lakhs of farmers?
Maybe, yeah, more than lakhs. Yeah.
What is the speed of these pumps that are...
Sir, these pumps are able to flow the water of 410,000 liters of water in a second.
So, just to give a good example, supposing you had to fill the Motera Stadium with water, how quickly would you...
Seconds only.
Okay, so that's the way water is being pumped at this enormous capacity over here. It's an engineering marvel by itself. Enabling the entire region, the Saurashtra region, in terms of the drought-prone area, what is the difference that this water has made? Earlier, what was the issue? And now, you've been an executive engineer, you lived here. What is the difference it has brought?
Sir, actually, I am basically from Saurashtra region, so I know the value of water, and those are very scarce area. But after this canal network is already there and it is developed, so it is. We are very happy that the water is reaching to the edges of the Gujarat state, like up to the Dwarka and Porbandar. That is very beneficial to all the...
Now, it's interesting that you actually belong and you benefit directly, your family benefits from this. What does your family say of the change? Earlier, when you lived in Saurashtra and you grew up over there, what was the condition? And now, because of this canal, how has it helped you?
Yeah, earlier, sir, we used to go to the farms or common well to fetch the water. And right now, we are very lucky that we open our taps in the home and we'll get the water there.
So this particular entire project that came up in 2015, was it? When was it finalized?
No, sir. It was in a phase-wise manner. So first phase was completed in 2007.
And the final phase?
Final phase. Right now, you can see the bigger building is of the phase 3 and 4. It was completed in 2020 only, just recently.
So it is just about finished. It has been a long haul. It is finally done. And now Saurashtra will not only get what it was getting earlier, but about 2-3 times the amount to all the farmers in the region that's there. And that's what is transforming Gujarat. This, just to remind you, is a water-starved region of Gujarat. The second big thing that Narendra Modi as Chief Minister did for water supply was that he insisted that the management of drinking water and irrigation should have total people's participation. He broke down the bureaucratic structure of the water department into autonomous bodies to do just that. For drinking water, it meant that right from the construction of the elevated storage reservoir or overhead tank for each village, there would be a Pani Samiti or a water committee consisting of the people of the village, preferably women, who would operate and manage the water supply. To oversee and facilitate such community participation, the Gujarat government created a separate entity called the Water and Sanitation Management Organization, or WASMO. I visited the Motipura Veda village in Mansa Taluka in Gandhinagar district to understand just how the Pani Samiti works.
Hello, I'm Raj Chengappa, and I'm at Motipura village in Mansa district in Gujarat. And in front of me is a Pani Samiti. This village 10 years ago was water short. They had to dig bore wells that was almost 1,000 feet deep to get water, till the Gujarat Water Supply Board put up a water tank, and they started the Pani Samiti, which is a very unique concept of allowing the people and the community to manage the entire water supply of this place.
Pani ka hamari yahan ek borewell tha, lekin wo 1000 feet se niche tha. To pani bahut TDS wala aur bahut kala pani aata tha, jo hamare swasthya ke liye acha nahi tha. Phir Wasmo wale yahan aaye और उन्होंने हमें गाइडलाइन किया और यहाँ उन्होंने हमें नर्मदा युद्ध योजना का पानी दिया और इसके बाद से हमारे यहाँ नर्मदा का पानी आ रहा है. बोरवेल का पानी था तो बोर खराब हो जाता था, तो हम लोगों को पास के खेतों के बोरों से पानी लाना था. तो हमारे टाइम बहुत जाता था, हमारे बच्चों के लिए टाइम नहीं निकल पा रहा
था. होता है जब बोरवेल का पास जाकर पानी लेकर वहाँ पर
2 घंटा हो जाता है सारे घर का पानी लाने में. अभी फ्री है क्योंकि गल पे 100% नल है और पानी भी आ जाता है.
वास्मो जो है वो सोशल मोबिलाइजेशन ज़्यादा करता है और हम पर्टिकुलर वुमन के ऊपर फोकस करते हैं ताकि महिलाएं आगे आए और महिलाएं खुद उनके प्रॉब्लम्स बताएं, क्योंकि पूरा दिन पानी उनको यूज़ करना होता है. तो वो लोग अपने प्रॉब्लम्स बताएं, पानी समिति में भी वो ही मेम्बर हो तो वो खुद उनके प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व कर सके.
Today, out of the 18,191 villages in Gujarat, there are 17,899 villages, or 98% of them, who have Pani Samitis managing their own water supply, as we saw in Motipura Veda village. For irrigating farms too, people's participation was brought in by the Gujarat government, with farmers forming water user associations that would be in charge of distribution of water to individual farms in their village. Here is one example of farmers' associations opening the valve in the night to provide water to the fields of the association members. If they operate and maintain the supply the water board gives them for irrigation, then a huge discount for doing so will be given to them, apart from the farmers themselves choosing the timing for supply and the quantity they would like to supply every day or every season. The third big thing that Narendra Modi did as Chief Minister was to strengthen the traditional water bodies and resources to ensure that they were not neglected, so that they could provide additional water supply to the people and also in areas where the canal water, the Narmada canal water, cannot be supplied. I went to Raj Sitapur, a village in Surendranagar district, to see for myself how that work was done.
I'm sitting on the banks of a check dam that is built on Raj Sitapur, a village in Surendranagar district. Now, this particular village, right through all the years before, was highly drought prone. Water availability was there only when it rained, and that was scarce. And when it didn't rain, the people not only couldn't grow their crops, but had drinking water issues. Since the Department of Irrigation constructed this check dam behind me, they in fact have built a series of check dams, which is starting from here, there are 5 more check dams that go down this and store water when it rains. Otherwise, earlier, this water used to drain and be not available for the farmers' use. I have with me here Mr. Patel, who's actually helped in building this check dam. Mr. Patel, ye check dam pehle kya problem tha aur ye check dam kyun laga hai yahan pe?
Oh, pehle jo barish ka pani, jo zyada barish hoti thi, phir bhi nadi mein aise hi वेस्टेज में बह जाता था। अभी वो चेकडैम बनने से पानी का स्टोर हुआ और आजू बाजू के जो भी फार्मर्स लोग हैं इसका यूज़ करके इसका जो क्रॉप में ज़्यादा से मैक्सिमम बेनिफिट ले रहे हैं और इसकी वजह से इसका जो फैमिली जो लाइफलाइन वो बहुत अच्छी तरह से बढ़ रहा है।
और डिपार्टमेंट ने कितने खर्च किया और कितने चेक डैम्स लगाए हैं यहाँ?
ये जो चेक डैम है राज सीतापुर का, इसका 50 लाख का खर्चा हुआ है, वो गवर्नमेंट ने बेयर किया है, फार्मर्स लोग का इसमें कोई हिस्सा नहीं है। और ये नदी के ऊपर अपस्ट्रीम साइड में एक चेक डैम बनाया है और डाउनस्ट्रीम में 4 चेक डैम एग्जिस्टिंग अभी बन चुका है और इसका सभी गांव वालों इसका बेनिफिट ले रहे हैं।
किसान का खेतों कुछ नहीं लिया आपने, बस इसकी सरकार की लैंड के नदी का लैंड पे लगाया और डैम लगाया था।
नदी का जो लैंड था इसका ही लैंड में हमने कंस्ट्रक्ट किया है और फार्मर्स का कोई जमीन का हमने यूज नहीं किया है।
मेरे पास भी है एक किसान इसी गांव से, पटेल जी, आपका नाम भी पटेल, महेश पटेल है। महेश पटेल, ये चेक डैम पहले आने के बाद पहले नहीं था तो क्या प्रॉब्लम था, क्या तकलीफ था?
जब ये चेक डैम नहीं था तो हम साल में एक ही बार जब वर्षा ऋतु थी तभी पाक ले सकते थे, और जब ये चेक डैम हुआ तो इसके कारण इसकी वजह से हम साल में 3 फसल भी ले सकते हैं, 3 पाक भी ले सकते हैं। बहुत ज़्यादा हमारी आय भी जो है वो दुगनी हो गई है और बहुत ज़्यादा फायदा हुआ है इस चेक डैम लगने से। पहले क्या था, पानी बह जाता था और पानी का जल स्तर है वो भी 400-500 फीट से ज़्यादा हो गया था, लेकिन इस चेक डैम की वजह से पानी भी ऊपर आया है और बहुत ज़्यादा फायदा हुआ है।
और इसकी पीने के पानी क्या तकलीफ है? इसके ये चेक डैम भी दे सकता है पीने का पानी, नहीं अलग से कुछ चाहिए थे?
चेक डैम जो कैनल है वहीं से, और चेक डैम की वजह से पीने का पानी भी यहाँ लग सकते हैं। हम खेत में भी आते हैं तो यही पानी का यूज करते हैं हम।
इन द पास्ट 2 decades मोर देन 1.84 लाख चेक डैम्स हैव बीन बिल्ट अपार्ट फ्रॉम 3.27 फार्म पॉन्ड्स। अपार्ट फ्रॉम दीस 31,500 ponds have been deepened to enhance capacity and about 1,000 abandoned step wells have been revived, cleaned and put to use, all to augment water. The fourth big thing that Narendra Modi did as Chief Minister was to begin a massive subsidy scheme to incentivize farmers to take up modern micro-irrigation practices that could save an enormous amount of water. He set up the Gujarat Green Revolution Company to facilitate the process, and right from providing subsidy to handholding the farmer through the first 2 seasons, the company would be involved. To understand how it works, I visited Khoraj village in Gandhinagar district, where a farmer had just switched to micro irrigation, and officials there spoke to me. Here is my report.
I'm in Goraj village, and this is in Sanand in Gujarat, not far from Ahmedabad. And what is happening around me is probably the future of farming. If you see, this is almost 10 hectares of micro irrigation farming, which means using drip irrigation to grow crops. I have with me here Hardik Pancholi, who is the project in charge of the Gujarat Green Revolution Corporation. Tell our listeners very simply, what is the difference between micro irrigation and the regular irrigation that you have, that farmers do? What is so special about micro irrigation?
Actually, when we just compare both the traditional irrigation and micro irrigation, then in traditional irrigation we are just giving huge quantity, and that is not a perfect irrigation. Actually, they are just we were just irrigating a whole farm. Now in this case we are irrigating the plants. We are just understanding that what actually the requirement of farm, the water requirement of farm, and in subsequent year subsequently we are also giving the fertilizers, that water soluble fertilizer, the requirement of fertilizer we are giving them through drip irrigation. So there is no any means the efficiency of fertilizer is also getting at its maximum.
Supposing you did the regular irrigation, how much more water would you be using as compared? How much less water do you use because of micro irrigation?
Actually, less than 50% would be required compared to the traditional irrigation, because we can understand that we are not irrigating whole farm. We are just understanding and the root zone that we are focusing on, the droplets would be reaching directly to the root zone and it will be take up by the plant actually.
But how expensive is it to lay these pipes like these? Plus you can see the bed of that other, muskmelon that you are growing over here.
Yes.
What is the cost differential? What is the cost differential that you have?
Actually, for traditional irrigation, there is no cost investment. But for drip irrigation, the initial investment would be ranging from 80,000 to 1 lakh per hectare. And but the plus point is that government is ultimately giving more than 70 to 90% of subsidy considering the farmer's category. So after all, farmer has to pay his share, that is ranging from 30%, means 30,000 to 42,000, that's it. So farmers are getting, it is okay that they are investing at the initial, but the life of this system is more than 7 to 9 years. So after all, after once investment is done, then they are reaping these benefits and harnessing these benefits for the upcoming years.
So but there is also the other issue that you must have proper power, proper water, because otherwise if you don't have these things, this must be using, when you are putting a drop and pumping it, you would definitely require some power. Yes. And that means regular power. Now, is this feasible across, all the farmers or only a select number of farmers?
No, actually, to adopt the micro irrigation, there is a prerequisite. First, you must have the water source. And the second, you must have the facility to pump the water, because this is not a gravity feed. And we are just pumping it, because to run the micro irrigation system, there must be need of at least 1 kg per centimeter square pressure to operate this system. That is technological requirement. So if the farmers do have this facility, then they are free to adopt it. They can adopt this system and they can start harnessing the benefits of the system.
So as we have seen here, this entire experiment that is going on is the future of farming. There are prerequisites for it. You do require power, as Hardik was saying, you do require water. There is a water source over there where it is being pumped. You do require good electricity supply that is there, and you do require technical knowledge. It will take a little time. In the first year, the farmer is able to get the help of the government and all the specialists, but the hope is that they would adopt this thing. Countries like Israel have demonstrated that this is the way forward. Ye aap pehle kisan kya kya fasal dalte aur kyu micro irrigation se shuru kiya?
Pehle hum gehun aur arandi aise fasal lete the, lekin aisa socha isme kharch zyada hai, aamdani kam hoti jati rahi, isliye ek do jagah pe dekha ki ye karne mein munafa zyada rehta hai, isliye humne dusre ka dekh ke ye agle saal se wahi kiya hai.
और इसमें क्या लाभ मिला अभी तक? अभी तब शुरू हो गया, सरकार ने पैसे दिया, आपको सब्सिडी भी दिया था. क्या फर्क है जब फार्मिंग करेंगे ना? आप पहले भी गेहूं डालते हैं, कितने कम पानी होता है इसमें और कितने इसकी जो फर्टिलाइजर्स भी डालते हैं, कितने कम होता है उसका?
इसमें मेरे ख्याल से 80% पानी की बचत होती है, मजदूरी भी कम लगती है, खरपतवार भी कम होते हैं, और जो पौधे होते हैं उनको पानी की ज़रूरत नहीं होती है, नमी की ज़रूरत होती है. तो ये ड्रिप से नमी मिल ही जाती है, तो पानी का बचाव होता है, खर्च का बचाव होता है, और पूरी तरह से इसमें फायदा ही फायदा है किसान.
नाउ ऑलमोस्ट 20% ऑफ गुजरात फार्मर्स लाइक रमेश भाई हैव अडॉप्टेड माइक्रो इरिगेशन प्रैक्टिसेस. The result of all these efforts by the Gujarat government, driven by the vision of Narendra Modi when he was Chief Minister of the state from 2002 to 2014, are the following. Firstly, irrigable area in the water-starved state has gone up by as much as 77% when compared to 2001. Secondly, groundwater recharge has gone by more than 55% during the same period. Both these meant that the farmers, instead of struggling to provide one crop annually, can now plant three crops annually, trebling their income. Thirdly, close to 95% of Gujarat villages have potable tap water supply in their houses, as compared to only an average of 33% in the rest of India. It has ended the drudgery of women in these villages, who had to waste more than 2 hours daily to collect water in the past, and has put them all on the road to emancipation. These are remarkable achievements for a water-starved state in just 2 decades. Now, as Prime Minister, Narendra Modi is implanting some of the big lessons he learned for providing water supply to the people of Gujarat to the rest of the country.
आने वाले दिनों में जल जीवन मिशन को लेकर के आगे बढ़ेंगे। ये जल जीवन मिशन इसके लिए करीब केंद्र और राज्य साथ मिलकर के काम करेंगे।
In our latest issue of India Today, we chronicle not only the success of Gujarat, but all other such examples and initiatives of people's participation and government action. Thank you for watching.